why you started painting, but I started painting because beauty really inspired me. I saw beautiful works of art and I just wanted to do that too. I wanted to create beauty. Apparently Van Gogh felt the same way. He said, "I long so much to make beautiful things, but beauty takes effort, disappointment, and perseverance." So I think that's a common journey for a lot of artists. The artistic, creative journey takes a lot of twists and turns, and it can go through some pretty dark valleys that can be really disconcerting. And if you're a beginner artist especially, I think that's when a lot of beginners think, "Oh, I just don't have any talent." I see a lot of beginners make the same mistake when they encounter these twists and turns. What I want to talk to you about today is a common mistake I see all beginners take, and it's in relation to all these twists and turns and how you manage them. Successful, groundbreaking artists like Van Gogh and Matisse must have all felt this way because they have a lot of quotes about this subject. What do you think, Kitty? Do you want to be like Van Gogh? You can't be Van Gogh, but you can be inspired by Van Gogh. I'll play sped up footage of my latest painting that itself inspired this video because I almost made the same mistake with this piece. Before we get to the ultimate mistake that I feel beginners make, let's talk about why they make it. The root cause of this mistake is fear. Fear can be a wonderful thing. It keeps us safe. It can even help us in painting. I find that when I approach a painting with too much confidence, I'm not careful enough with it, and it goes very sideways. Reverence is a beautiful version of fear, I think, and we need a healthy dose of that, I think, to respect the painting process enough to be mindful and thoughtful as we move through the painting process. But that being said, when fear encases us in a prison of inaction, it must be dealt with. I don't know if many of you know this, but I have a counseling master's degree. In my studies, I came across some research that has seriously benefited me in my most recent YouTube and painting journey that I'm on now. The researchers studied a group of people over their lifetime. Their goal was to tease out what personality characteristics that successful people had over those who were not successful. They came to the conclusion that it came down to one thing that really stood out that all the successful people had, and they called it grit. What is grit? It's a determination to keep getting up, no matter how many times you fall down. Hey, I even have a Van Gogh quote for that. He said, "Only when I fall do I get up again." He realized what a special time this is in his painting journey. When he falls down, that is an important time. It's pivotal to his success to keep getting up. So it was at this point in this painting that I'm showing you here that I almost put it away for good. I was questioning everything. Why am I even painting a calico cat? I've already done one for my students. And then there was the dislike of the painting itself. I thought it was fine, but fine was not good enough. I wanted it spectacular, and I felt this painting was just blah. By the way, almost every painting goes through the ugly stage. I actually made a whole video about that, and I'll link it here. During the ugly stage, it's good to take a step back, take a break, go pick some flowers, have some coffee. I myself put this painting away for several days, but as I was about to take it off the board and shelve it for good, I thought I would do one more session. And this is what you see me doing here. I put that beautiful purple in, and it's like the painting came alive in front of me. It was very exciting. Now please note, this doesn't always happen. Sometimes a painting just never comes together. But that is also just a normal part of the creative process. And this is the mistake I've been getting to in this whole video. One of the most common mistakes I see artists make. They get three quarters done and it enters the ugly stage and they think they messed it up. They have no talent. Who do I think I am? I'm never going to paint something beautiful. And that fear of failure makes them quit a painting before they should stop. So that's the number one mistake I see beginner artists, and even I was about to make it. They stop before they should. They don't push past the ugly stage and give the painting a chance to live up to its full potential. Van Gogh says, "Don't lose heart if it's very difficult at times. Everything will come out all right, and nobody can, in the beginning, do as he wishes." And he also said, "If you hear a voice within you say you cannot paint, then by all means paint, and that voice will be silenced." I've been painting 20 years and I still have painting failures, but I know from some of my successes that I can paint and you can too. Keep at it, have grit, stay inspired, take breaks, but always come back and keep trying. Push through that ugly stage. Paint something more than one time. That's why artists do studies. If you overwork something, try it again. But always come back and know you're not alone in your frustration. Thank you so much for watching, and please like and subscribe to my channel because I upload videos almost every week. Thank you to my supporters on Patreon, where I share behind the scenes videos, real-time tutorials, inspirations, new ideas and aha moments I have, favorite videos and books, and everything else I encounter as I go along my own artistic journey. I'd love to have you join. In fact, I just created a new inspiration tier that's only $3, where I post several times a week. Thanks so much again, everybody. Bye. Ooh, I'm sweating.